What about a mineralization tank in a system? Where does it fit in? I presume after the sump tank and before the grow beds on towers. What is the purpose of the mineralization tank and how does it function? My guess from the nomenclature is that it is where the minerals such as iron that are necessary for maintaining healthy and productive plants are introduced into the system. Is there any adverse impact that mineralization could have on the fish or other forms of aquaculture, i.e. prawns, mussels, crawdads, etc.? The School of Aquaponics. Jeffrey has some things on his mind about mineralization, and that is totally fine because we need to know a thing or two about mineralization. So the first question, where exactly does mineralization take place in the system? How do you plumb it in or where is it at? That's what we're gonna take care of first. So there's pretty much two ways that you can, well, maybe more, but two prominent ways that you can induce some type of mineralization effect inside of your system. The first way is a lot of people use, the majority of people are gonna be using, is some type of the media bed. This is where solid waste is gonna accumulate and then eventually mineralization will take place inside of the media bed, whether it's a flood and drain system or if it's a continuous flow media bed. This is one aspect or one place where mineralization can take place. Well, on the other spectrum, which is what we typically use, is a separate mineralization tank, totally separate from the system. It connects from the mechanical filter where the solid waste that is accumulated gets drained into its own separate tank. And it's totally outside of the recirculating system that we have. And it's just doing its own thing and it's functioning separately from the rest of the system. Now, on to the next question. What exactly is mineralization? What's going on and what is this process? And if it's something that you actually need inside of your system. So mineralization, to give you just a basic overview of it, is basically the releasing of macro and micronutrients by heterotrophic bacteria. In your system, you're gonna have particulate organic carbon in the forms of fish feces, fish feed, and dead organisms. And all these have nutrients that are locked up in organic compounds, and these bacteria, heterotrophic bacteria, they basically just break them down, use the carbon, and then they release the nutrients. They change the chemical composition and release nutrients to the plant. So basically what we're doing is just efficiently using our nutrients. This is basically just efficiency, getting the most out of our fish feed that we put in, getting most out of the ecosystem that we have constructed. So we have organic compounds in the presence of bacteria, which then release inorganic anions and cations that the plants are able to use. This is basically just what's happening with the mineralization process. And you can take these nutrients and reintroduce them back into your system after you filter them out, or you can use them for any other type of soil, plants that you have growing or anything. They're just provided and packed with nutrients. And that's pretty much the gist of mineralization. Now, to answer your last question on, do they have any adverse impact on any other type of organisms, the fish, any other type of aquatic creatures that you may add into the system? And the answer is no. It's the same process that's taking place already in your system. All you're doing is just getting efficiency out of it and just, you know, you're just getting the most out of the ecosystem. So it doesn't have any adverse impact. As long as you're not introducing high levels of ammonia, if you're doing it correctly, then you shouldn't have any problems. If you're not introducing high levels of ammonia back into your system, or nitrite back into your system, if you're not doing anything like that, then you shouldn't have any issues with introducing just regular nutrients that your system already has inside of it already. So you shouldn't expect any adverse or negative impacts with mineralization just on its own. So that's pretty much the gist of it. So if anyone else has any other questions, feel free to ask. We're here. We want to help as many people as we can. Aquaponics is on the rise. Woo! Talk to us. Have a nice day.